be on the withers?
So that's a really, really good question, because I think that is so misunderstood out there. And this is probably the first question what every person who learns how to put a saddle on the horse should ask and should understand why. So let's look at the saddle tree. Now, I got all kinds of saddle trees here from all kinds of different manufacturers. This is not to make this saddle good, this saddle bad. It gives you an idea what a saddle tree looks like. You have the webbing and the seat foam. The stirrup bar is attached on 99.9% of all saddles towards the gullet plate and towards the front. And when the saddle is made, you see the plate here. And what hides this, so you don't see the bottom, it's what we call a gullet leather. So that leather is very, very thin. It's as thin as my shirt here. So that shirt or that piece of leather hides the bottom so you don't see it. So the protection from the horse's bone, so let's use, here we got a pony leg. You see the upper arm, and this is the scapular. So let's pretend, I have another piece that's maybe easier to show. This is the bottom from the pony leg. So let's pretend this is the top of the withers. Okay, so the top of the withers, when the horse moves, okay, if the horse moves properly, like Gerd always like to say, Gerd Hirschman like to say, I want to have a back mover, what moves to the back, not a rigid, stiff, locked back and just flicking his leg, right? We don't want leg movers who just flick his leg and his hind legs on La La Land and he's hollowing in pain. A good back mover, what moves, also swings his trunk. And the longest bone, this is not it, it's just an example. The longest bone on the withers goes actually back and forth, back and forth. So when you put a saddle on the horse and you want to clear the withers, okay, or the bone, think about it. There's very, very little protection here. So when you put the saddle on loose, you want to have a minimum of 2 to 3 fingers. This is from the old, old schools. Taught by men for men, 2 to 3 male fingers. That means for you ladies, 3 to 4 lady fingers, okay? So you want to have a minimum from 5 centimeter to 7.5 centimeter, okay? So why do you want that much room? By the time you sit on top, by the time you girth them up, this will come down. It won't stay there, okay? It will come down. So when you put the saddle loose on it, and this is the bone clearance from the distance to the top and the bone, you want a minimum of 2 to 3 male fingers. Here comes the most important part. When the horse is a nice mover, you don't want to hit it on the side. When I say 2 to 3 finger clearance, I also mean to the side. That would be where my thumb is right here. This is so important. Many people just focus here. But for all of you who like to go for trail riding, for all of you who like to do show jumping or dressage, don't you want the horse to turn? Don't you want the horse to bend nicely through his ribs? Do you think that saddle bends from here to here? It doesn't. Whoa, I got a spring tree. Okay, here the spring steel is loose, so it springs very easy. So what if it does it this way? I can't make that candle and the pommel bend here. It doesn't bend like my arm, okay? It doesn't do it this way. So if you ride around the corner, the last thing you want to do is damage the horse on the side. And like we learned from our experts who studied horses over and over and over again, okay? When we understand how much movement there is, and you want to have this big shoulder to come through there and you don't have that clearance, how is that shoulder ever to come through it? Yeah, but when I have it 3 to 4 lady fingers, then I'm sitting off my horse way too high. Really? Do you sit on the pommel or you sit in the deepest part close to the horse's back? If you like to sit up here, yeah, you sit too high. But this comment, I'm sitting away from my horse, is quite misunderstood, because where you actually should sit, in the middle of the saddle, you sit very, very close to the horse. So the clearance for the horse's shoulder, like you see in this picture, or you'll see, if you don't have that clearance, that damage will happen. Okay? How can you ever, watch this video, how is that shoulder ever to go through it if you don't have the clearance to start with? So I can only compliment you for asking this question. And I hope that many, many, many people see this and understand the proper clearance on top is just as much important and on the side. How do I create the side width? You create it by having the right tree width. If you ignore it, you see it like in this. This is from the University of Switzerland. They done a lot of tests. Horse number B, postmortem, a lot of problems on the withers and the left shoulder damage because it is not high enough on the withers. Okay, so I hope I answered that question, that you have to have minimum 3 to 4 lady fingers clearance on top of a bone and on the side of the bone from that nasty, nasty metal all saddle habit. That little leather will not protect your horse.